Thank you so much for joining us and looking at the two-year bond auction. It closed today. We had some investors saying that bidding could hit levels of about 15. What could happen to the market if that level is below that?
Basically, I think 15% is more on the higher side. There were investors who did go in at such levels, but what this would serve to do is basically to drive up the market average of all the bids. But we expect the average that the central bank may accept to be anywhere between 12 to 13%. So what this will do actually is it will immediately pull up the curve at the short end. Currently, the two-year paper is trading at between levels of 10.75 to 11%. So this would immediately pull the curve back up. What we'd have is a curve that would be rather flat. If you remember, the 15-year that was issued a month ago, it was issued at a yield of 12%. It's been trading thereabouts for the last 4 weeks. This would immediately put a lot of investors underwater for papers that such as the 5-year, the infrastructure bonds, all of which were trading at levels of between 10 and 11%, and all these are 5-year papers. So I think the people who'd feel the pinch the most are those at in the medium term tenors.
Keeping with the secondary market, we know that the government is expected to auction a few bills in this week's session. What kind of performance are you perhaps seeing coming through for the 91 day as well as the 182 day?
The 91 day has been performing pretty weakly. Subscriptions have been low, although the yields have been moving up. Last week was about 9.8. But I think most of the interest is focused more on the repo market, which is offering just about the same return, albeit for shorter periods of 7 to 28 days. But we've seen strong performance on the 182 day last week, which has not been the case. This was, I think, probably because we're seeing double-digit returns now. That it's at 10.5%. And this is quite attractive for investors who are looking into lock in money for 6 months. I think as we have 364-day T-bill in November, this should also get quite a lot of interest because people are looking for a double-digit return, locking your money 6 to 12 months.
Looking at the equity market, we had turnover being relatively high in today's trading session. Talk us through what the kind of movement that we saw coming in today, the market ending up almost 0.5% to the good. Are foreigners still the major drivers on that front?
Yes, they actually are. We saw turnover move up by about 17% up from yesterday. The market news has been pretty impressive yesterday and today. We expect this to hold for most of the week as we're seeing foreigners chasing down banking stocks. The results are expected within the next 2 weeks. I think the first results should be coming out towards the end of this week. And as usual, the banks are expected to show a strong performance. So we've had a lot of interest. Barclays today, which opened at about 14.65, went up all the way to 15.50, which is quite impressive. We also saw a lot of foreign presence on KCB. We're expecting this stock to most probably touch 30 shillings. This seems to be a resistant level at about 29.50, but once this is broken, we may see it go up all the way to, I think the last high, which was about 18 to 24 months ago, was about 33. So this is an interesting stock to watch. We've also seen foreigners chasing down dividend stocks, stocks such as EABL and BAT. This is basically for, dividend hunters for dividend-linked funds. So the performance is quite strong. We expect it to hold the rest of the week. Once results are out, we may see sell-offs as people begin to take profits. But we've been saying, we expect the market to mostly trade flat for most of this quarter.
Let's move on to the MPC. MPC expected to meet in about 2 weeks' time. Most analysts saying that we could possibly see a cut coming through there, but there's also a risk of the rising fuel prices that we have seen coming through. How much of an impact do you see that having on the decision in 2 weeks' time?
I think the MPC will most probably be looking keenly at inflation numbers. As you mentioned, fuel prices have been rising over the last 2 months. This puts upward pressure on inflation numbers. which is what CBK have been really trying to keep under control. So the MPC will also be keenly looking at this. Also, the other thing is the currency, as you've mentioned, it closed today at 85.15. It's been weakening, so they'll also be looking at this. So the cut that is expected by the market might not be as aggressive as we've seen in the last two MPC meetings. Most of the market at this time expects anywhere between 100 and 150 basis points. It's still a bit early. A lot may change in the last 2 weeks, as we've seen with the two-year bond auction that we expected at 11 and now we expect at 12.5. So yes, we expect 150 basis points, but this may change as we draw closer to that day and also as market variables change.